And now what about the climate in Switzerland? Well, unlike in Indonesia that has only two seasons, Switzerland has, in terms of climate, you know that Indonesia is a tropical country. Meaning that, and by the way, did you know that Indonesia has three different time zones? And camping is one of the very good active outdoor activities. So what about the populations? Did you know what is the populations in Indonesia and Switzerland? In this video, I'm going to talk about, guess what? Well, you have already seen the title on your screen, so nothing is new for you, right? All right, the topic is about the differences between two countries, i.e. Indonesia and Switzerland. Although some people know about the differences, I'm sure that many people still don't know yet. And these countries appeal to tourists from everywhere to pay a visit for their personal reasons. So, what are the actual differences and why is it necessary to know? Well, you better stay tuned on this channel as I'll be back right after this intro. Hey everyone, it's Didi here and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in this video, I'm going to tell you about the differences between Indonesia and Switzerland in some categories. And I wish that it could enrich your general knowledge. And the question is, what makes these countries different from each other? Well, let's have a look at the following categories together. Okay? Capital city, geography, climate, time zones, land area, number of islands, and the populations. Compulsory education, university, literacy, literate ranking, religions, languages, political systems, healthcare system, life expectancy, economics such as monetary unit, exchange rate, economic sources, and their international trades. The capital city of Indonesia is Jakarta, and Bern is the capital city of Switzerland. Geographically speaking, Indonesia is one of the countries in the Southeast Asia, in the Asian continent. It is very close to Malaysia, Singapore, Brunei Darussalam, and East Timor. Meanwhile, Switzerland is located in Central Europe. It is in the European continent. To get a better understanding of it, let's have a look at this world map so that you know where the island nation and Switzerland are located. All these islands belong to Indonesia. It's a huge country, isn't it? And this one here is Switzerland, where the country is located. The very close neighboring countries from Switzerland are France, Germany, Italy, Austria, and Liechtenstein. In terms of climate, you know that Indonesia is a tropical country, meaning that the sun is almost shining all year long. And it's very humid. The level of humidity is approximately 70 to 90%. Furthermore, it has only two seasons, dry and wet seasons. Dry season or summer, it starts in April and ends in October. And wet season is the raining period from November to March. Nevertheless, due to the climate change, the said seasons are not easily predicted. And the average temperature in Indonesia alone is about 25 degrees Celsius and 32 degrees Celsius, depending on the island. And by the way, did you know that Indonesia has three different time zones? Well, you better know, because it has Western, Central, and Eastern time zone. I'll give you an example. In Western part of Indonesia, now it's 5 o'clock a.m. In Central of Indonesia, it is at 6 a.m. and 7 a.m. in the eastern part of Indonesia. So for Western, from Western to Eastern, it has 2 hours difference. And now what about the climate in Switzerland? Well, unlike in Indonesia that has only two seasons, Switzerland has four seasons within a year, i.e. autumn, winter, spring, and summer. Right now is at the end of the autumn, meaning that winter is about to come. After that, spring comes, and then summer is to return. You know that in winter time, the temperature can be minus X degrees Celsius, so it is very, cold. But did you know that Swiss or people live in Switzerland like winter sports, such as skiing, snowboarding, randonning on the mountains with their racket? And I myself, I love this winter sport, such as ski. And if you guys want to know me skiing around in the mountain, you can click here in the card, or I'll give you the link in the description below. Spring is a beautiful season because the weather is good, the temperature is getting warm, and the flowers are blooming despite the fact that it rains from time to time. What I like in spring is that, you know, when waking up in the morning, I can hear the birds singing. And you know that having breakfast in the morning and listening to these birds chanting at the same time is, you know, making my day beautiful. Can you imagine that? And yes, summer is what Swiss are waiting for because they can go swimming in the Rhine, in the Rhone, or in the lakes. They can also have barbecue at some places. Having picnic outside or outdoor in the garden or public parks is always agreeable. And camping is one of the very good active outdoor activities during summer. You know, sunset in summer, it is about at 9:30 p.m. So daytime lasts longer than the nighttime. About the time zone, Switzerland doesn't have different time zone. But the people here, they have to change their time twice a year. For example, in March, they have to adjust their time an hour ahead. And then in October, they have to readjust the time 1 hour later. So this is very unique to me personally because it doesn't exist in Indonesia. Now let me tell you about the difference in the sense of land area. Indonesia total land area is about 1.9 hundred million square kilometers. And Switzerland has total land area about 41.8 hundred million square kilometers. You know, Indonesia is island nations, as I mentioned earlier. Now the question is that, how many islands does Indonesia have? 10, 100, or 200? The right answer is that Indonesia has more than 17,000 islands, and therefore it has three different time zones. Does Switzerland has also islands? Yes, it has islands. It has, I think, if I'm not mistaken, it has 11 islands. But the difference is that the islands in Switzerland are not meant for living because there is no economic activity. All the islands in Switzerland are regarded as tourist destinations because they are located between the lake and the river. So what about the populations? Did you know what is the populations in Indonesia and Switzerland? Well, I'll tell you what, guys. Indonesia is the fourth populated nation in the world. It has more than 270 million of people. And the most populated island is Java, contributing to 57% of the total populations. And the second populated island is Sumatra, which accounts for 21% of the total populations. And did you know what is the population in Switzerland? Switzerland has 8.5 million of people. The largest canton is Zurich, followed by Bern, and then Canton Vaud, and then the largest, another large city is Geneva, where I'm living now. Well, I guess that's a lot for today. So should I stop here or continue? All right, I think I better terminate here and then I'll continue on telling you the remaining categories later in the next video. So if you like this video, please give your thumbs up and don't forget to click subscribe and press the bell icon too so that you will get the first notifications once the second video of the same topic is uploaded. Comments, feedback are highly appreciated, and take care. Thanks a lot for watching, and see you soon. Ciao.